Hi, how are you? I hope you're having a great day. I do so much better with maintaining my weight and losing weight when I'm not eating carbohydrates. But the problem for me is that if I'm not eating any carbohydrates, I feel sluggish. So while researching, I ran across an article on the use of D-ribose for fibromyalgia and chronic fatigue. Now, I'll be honest, I was unsure and I haven't started taking
But
it yet.
according to a pilot study by Dr. Tittlebaum,
66% of patients with fibromyalgia experience significant improvement in sleep, mental clarity, and pain intensity, with an average increase of energy of 45% improvement. Their overall improvement in well-being was 30%. Well, that's not bad. In a study that followed, 61% reported significant improvement in energy and 37% in well-being. So that's what I want to talk about today. D-ribose is a naturally occurring pentose carbohydrate, meaning it's naturally occurring in our body as a simple sugar carbohydrate. Based on studies, D-ribose is believed to help cells recover by replacing energy stores in muscle cells. That sounds good. It supports the production of adenosine triphosphate, or ATP, which creates energy in your heart and skeletal muscles. It helps your heart muscles pump out blood that benefits every cell and system in the body. People take it after heavy exercise to replace the lost energy in their cells. For those who do a major exercise routine, D-ribose doesn't help their exercise improve, but helps to ease their muscle tension and to recover the ATP levels lost in their muscle tissues. It's marketed mostly for athletes. In Europe, it appears D-ribose is added to certain foods and has been found safe. It increases the amount of your cell's primary energy source, ATP, a compound present in all living tissue. It drives muscle contraction and nerve impulses. It's naturally occurring in our DNA and our RNA. It's a sugar molecule that our body naturally produces, but you can get it in supplement tablets or powder. Also, in people who have low fitness levels, it appears it may improve performance in healthy individuals. 10 grams were necessary a day for improvement. Research evidence seems to support D-ribose. It may improve heart function, but it appears that for heart function improvement, 15 to 60 grams per day is necessary. It seems to be well tolerated, although Dr. Tittlebaum stated that two patients felt too energized and hyper anxious, so they lowered the dosage and they took it with food. The side effects occur because ribose has a negative glycemic index. It lowers blood sugar. Although rarely, a rise in blood sugar occurs. So if you have low blood sugar, it's not recommended to take these supplements or when combined with diabetes medication. Bipolar patients should take it with caution because prescription medicine may interact. And those taking warfarin
It's important to check for bleeding. Also, in their 2012 study, one patient discontinued use of D-ribose because of increased insomnia. Another quit taking it because they became ill, which wasn't related to the D-ribose. And yet another stated they quit taking it because they became nauseous. Other side effects might be diarrhea, gastrointestinal discomfort, nausea, as I just stated, and headache. You shouldn't take it for 2 weeks after surgery. So always, always, always talk to your doctor. Manufacturers don't need FDA approval, but the FDA will take action against any unsafe supplement after it reaches the market. So do your research. Dr. Tietelbaum and colleagues performed several studies. Their recommendation is to take 5 milligrams 3 times a day for 6 weeks, then 5 grams 2 times a day for 6 more weeks to determine if it works for you. In 2006, 2008, and 2012, studies were performed. They claimed that it also helped with restless leg syndrome. Many of us with fibro have that. Mitochondrial malfunctions can create many problems. The hypothalamus in the brain controls our sleep, the pituitary gland, which produces, stores, and releases hormones, and our autonomic nervous system is affected in fibromyalgia. These functions are recognized as problems in the brain, heart, skeletal muscles, liver, and endocrine systems. Ribose is given to energy-deficient hearts and athletes to stimulate energy recovery. The hypothalamus is recognized as a key center for regulating sleep. Immune suppression occurs when we don't get enough sleep, especially in those with insomnia. Our autonomic system regulates our blood pressure, pulse, sweating, and peristalsis, the function that is involuntary that controls the relaxation and constriction of the muscles of the intestine that push contents forward. Because the autonomic nervous system is affected in fibromyalgia, it explains why we may struggle with one or more problems in this area, such as POTS, vasovagal syncope, IBS, small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, and unusual sweating. When you think of the pituitary endocrine function, think hormone dysfunction like growth hormone and thyroid hormone, as well as cortisol and oxytocin for male and female reproductive systems. It also helps the body regulate water and sodium balance in the body. The dysfunction in the brain, skeletal muscles, liver, endocrine, and heart result in brain fog and heart dysfunction seen in chronic fatigue. The fatigue, increased thirst, I'm constantly thirsty, and urination issues are in part due to the low energy production because of excessive amounts of lactic acid in the muscles that's found in CFS and fibro. Also, it's the decreased ability of the liver to eliminate toxins and medications that can lead to medication and environmental allergies. Some call this leaky gut. So what they found, is that from previous research, CFS and fibro cause the body to dump key energy molecules like carnitine as well as ribose. This leaves us feeling sluggish and fatigued. To quote Dr. Tietelbaum, he stated, "It makes it hard to get the mitochondrial furnaces working again, and even after other problems were treated." He stated this was a eureka moment. Try building a fire without kindling. Nothing's going to happen. And then in their 2006 study, it took 12 days on average for patients to feel better. That's not bad. So this is one testimony by a patient. I had so much pain and fatigue. I thought I was going to have to quit teaching. When I take ribose, I feel like a huge weight is being lifted from my chest, and I'm ready to take on those kids again. It's not often that I'm fascinated by a supplement. Very few nutritional therapies can boast of having such a profound impact on the tissues they target, especially metabolism. This could be life-changing for some of us. Check with your doctor and be sure it's safe for you. And apparently we can take it every day. You can buy D-Ribose easily through Amazon or a health supplement store. And I've seen it on the online Walmart app. Just make sure there's a D and not an L in front of it. D-Ribose. You can also get it naturally from foods such as mushrooms, beef and poultry, cheddar cheese and cream cheese, milk, eggs, caviar. Never had that. Anchovies, herring, and sardines, as well as yogurt. However, you can't get enough from food sources to meet the doses recommended by supplement manufacturers. So what do you think? It might be worth trying if you have extreme fatigue with your fibromyalgia or your chronic fatigue syndrome. But I'd really like to know what you think. I hope you learned something. I send you gentle hugs and support. Love you. And 30 and 30 mitochondrial malfunctions. Increased ability. Stability of the liver. He's also hugs and support.